In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, coming together as God's family, let us call to mind our sins and shortcomings, and ask the Lord for His pardon and mercy as we prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are the Good Shepherd leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins. And bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that the course of our world may be directed by your peaceful rule, and that your church may rejoice untroubled in her devotion. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Peter. Beloved, concerning the salvation of your souls, the prophets who prophesied about the grace that was to be yours searched and investigated it, investigating the time and circumstances that the Spirit of Christ within them indicated when it testified in advance to the sufferings destined for Christ and the glories to follow them. It was revealed to them that they were serving not themselves, but you with regard to the things that have now been announced to you by those who preach the good news to you through the Holy Spirit sent from heaven, things into which angels long to look. Therefore, gird up the loins of your mind, live soberly, and set your hopes completely on the grace to be brought to you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Like obedient children, do not act in compliance with the desires of your former ignorance, but as He who called you is holy, be holy yourselves in every aspect of your conduct, for it is written, "Be holy, because I am holy." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord has made known His salvation.
The Lord has made known His salvation.
Sing to the Lord a new song, for He has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for Him, His holy arm.
The Lord has made known His salvation.
The Lord has made His salvation known. In the sight of the nations, He has revealed His justice. He has remembered His kindness and His faithfulness toward the house of Israel.
The Lord has made known His salvation.
All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song, sing praise.
The Lord has made known His salvation. Please stand.
Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. You have revealed to little ones the mysteries of the kingdom.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Peter began to say to Jesus, "We have given up everything and followed you." Jesus said, "Amen, I say to you, there is no one who has given up house or brothers or sisters or mother or father or children or lands for my sake and for the sake of the gospel, who will not receive 100 times more now in this present age, houses and brothers and sisters and mothers and children and lands with persecutions and eternal life in the age to come. But many that are first will be last, and the last will be first." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Today's Gospel is a continuation of yesterday's story about the rich young man. And we cannot take away the story of yesterday with the good news of today and what seems to be that good news. The rich young man may have thought that once you give up everything, you will surely have nothing. Pero doon po siya nagkakamali. Hindi naman pinapabayaan o hinahayaan ng Diyos na mawalan ang sumusunod sa Kanya. Instead, the one who surrenders to God receives more from God. Peter told Jesus today, "We have given up everything to follow you. Kumbaga, sinabi po ni Pedro kay Jesus, wala na kaming itinera para sa aming sarili, para sundan ka. Isinuko na namin sa iyo. But Jesus answered him, Amen, I say to you, there is no one who has given up house or brothers and sisters and everything for my sake and for the sake of the gospel who will not receive 100 times more now in this present age. Not empty-handed, not rich in terms of earthly desires or things, but doubly blessed by the Lord. At sa umagang ito pa lang po, inialay na po natin sa Diyos ang pupwede o sanang inihaba na lang sanang tulog natin o ipinahinga na lang po ninyo mula po sa mga iba't ibang biyahe ninyo. But we are all here. You are watching, joining us online via online streaming. Nawalan man tayo ng para sa atin, pero tiyak din naman po tayo na tatanggap tayo ng biyaya mula sa Diyos natin. Madaming mga tao ang isinuko sa Diyos ang kanilang mga posibleng plano, pero nakadama na hindi naman nagkulang ang Diyos kung susuko at magbibigay para sa Diyos. With this vocation to the priesthood, madami-dami na din po kung isinuko at ipinagkatiwala o binitawan para sa Diyos. Mga posibleng plano na pwede ko naman po sanang harapin. Isang normal na buhay ng isang binata o isang lalaki. At madami pa pong ibang pagsusukong naganap sa buhay ni Father Viel. But have I grown less? All the more that I realized the one who surrenders to God, receives more from God. We may have a lot of fears, my dear brothers and sisters, when we surrender something or ourselves to God. Dahil hindi naman po madaling bumitaw o sumuko para sa Diyos. Nakakatakot pa nga, dahil ang pagsuko, ibig sabihin diyan may mawawala. Pero hindi po pabaya ang Diyos. God will not only supply, He will bless us. He promised that He will make it double for us. We will not go empty-handed, but full of His love, full of His blessings, and full of His grace.
Please stand.
Aware of the danger in putting our trust in the pleasures of this world, we lift up our hearts in fervent prayer to the Father. For every petition we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church throughout the world may be an effective sign of the way to everlasting happiness and eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may learn to trust in spiritual values which enrich our being and not in material possessions which bring discontent to our souls. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may never close our hearts to those in need, but consciously involve ourselves in Christ's work of healing and reconciling. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and the disabled may experience the Lord's care through the love of their neighbors and friends. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our deceased relatives and friends may enjoy God's peace in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In the silence of our hearts, let us lift up to the Lord all of the prayers offered in this Mass, the prayers of our brothers and sisters joining us via online streaming, and our prayers for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, look with compassion on the needy. Enlighten our lives with your truth and give us the grace to live out the high ideals put before us by your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who provide gifts to be offered to your name, and count our oblations as signs of our desire to serve you with devotion, we ask of your mercy that what you grant as the source of merit may also help us to attain merit's reward, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him, through Christ our Lord. Through him, the angels praise your majesty. Dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, that we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Oh,
Please stand.
Let us pray. Nourished by your saving gifts, we beseech your mercy, Lord, that by this same sacrament with which you feed us in the present age, you may make us partakers of life eternal, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.